Loyalty runs deep when you know how to apply it.
A big issue with the black community is loyalty, right? Now, here's how my loyalty is built. If me and you are A1 from day one, right? And I run into somebody on the street and I think they're cool. And I come back to you and be like, yo, I met such and such. And you be like, yo, I don't mess with them. I don't mess with them neither now.
Right.
They now the enemy because you my A1 from day one. I remember I had this friend and, you know, we were cool. And there's another person online who was kicking my back end, right? So I told this so-called friend of mine, like, yo, you know, this person kicks my back end. I showed them their criminal record, how they're a fraud. And this person still continues to follow and retweet this person. So I now have to cut this person off because your loyalty ain't built like mine. I'm only going to deal with people whose loyalty is built like mine.
It's a security risk, too.
It's a security risk.
It's definitely a security risk. And, you know, like recently I've had a situation where I'm tight with, you know, somebody. Mm-hmm. And they ain't never did nothing to me.
Okay.
Feel me? No reason for me to cut them out. But I had somebody literally come in and kick her back in. Mm. You know, and it was like they expected me to have loyalty for them instead of for her. And I'm sitting here to myself like, I'm a grown-ass woman. She ain't do nothing to me.
Right.
And you're reacting. A lot of people do it out of anger.
Mm-hmm.
And they're miserable.
Mm-hmm.
So they feel that, you know, I'm just going to go and, you know, attack everybody that's around this person.
Right.
And I'm like, no, we're not going to do that.
Right.
We're not going to do that. So it was just easier to just cut off two people. Instead of me cutting off that one person.
Mm-hmm.
For what? My loyalty, you know what? If I rock with you, I rock with you. You haven't done nothing to me. You haven't done nothing to me. And I'm not about to sit up here and I'm not about to check nobody. Because you know what?
Yeah.
If somebody that I rock with want to go and, you know, talk to somebody that I don't talk to, you know what? You go ahead and do that.
Right.
But I'm going to keep my distance.
I'm
going to keep my distance. But within the black community, it's like people, they don't understand what loyalty is. They flip-flop. And instead of, again, we're going to go back to white people.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of utilizing white people for their benefit, they'll flip-flop with black people that can't do shit for them.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about white people and loyalty. Because this has been my problem. I remember being in high school and this white girl would ask me, she was like, play with my hair in English class. You know, playing with people's hair is really soothing.
Mm-hmm.
She was an attractive white girl. I'd play with her hair. And then like, I'd see her in the hallway and she would act like she didn't know me. Like it'd be like let's say we had class together fourth period. Eighth period, she'd be in the hallway, walk right past me. But she wasn't the only person that was like this. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to talk to you about what happened on the soccer team too. But I noticed that all my so-called white friends will be cool with me when it's just me and them.
Because they can control it.
Right. But when they got around a group of people, it was uncool to be cool with me.
Yeah.
Because I'm a very opinionated person. I didn't give a fuck about nobody. So they'd be like, oh, you hang out with Brian Sharp? Like, yeah, I hang out with Brian Sharp. Nobody had the balls to say, yo, I hang out with Brian Sharp. I think he's cool.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Now, peep gang, what happened? I'm going to show you my type of loyalty. I was on a soccer bus, and we go into an away game. And now I had my homeboy. His name was Brian. His name was Brian, too. I forget his name. Brian Bianco. Brian Bianco, if you're listening, you my homie still.
Yeah.
He was a little slow. He was a little slow. I ain't going to lie. And the kids used to pick on him on the bus. So I remember this one white kid spit on him. So I got up, and I whooped his ass. I beat that white kid's ass. We're the same size. Ain't no problem. You can catch this fade. I got suspended from the soccer team, but he didn't. And I'm fighting for another white boy.
See, no, that's what you don't do.
That's what I shouldn't have did.
You shouldn't have done that.
I should have minded my business.
You should have minded
because
your business.
Because when it turned around for that white boy to defend me for defending him.
He didn't. He wasn't.
He was nowhere to be found.
See, that's why that loyalty is race-based. Period. But you know what? White people is not going to. I mean, you know what? I'm not going to say.
Got a handful. Got a couple that
will.
Right.
It's certain white people because you know what? I have a couple white friends and I know for a fact they will defend me if anything was to happen.
Right.
But a large majority of white people, they will expect you to defend them.
Right.
But when it's time for them to defend you, they're not going to do that because it makes them look like, oh, I'm sorry, excuse my French. Oh, you're a nigger lover? And they don't want to be called that.
Right.
So they're not going to do that. Right. So,
and there's another problem with, you know, so on Twitter, it seems like I hang out with white folks a lot, right? And I pretty much do. But what black people and those white people don't understand is I'm black first.
Yes, of course.
They might call that identity politics. I don't know what the hell identity politics is.
It's all these weird new terms for every little thing instead of everybody's just making this whole world confusing.
Right.
What is identity politics?
Basically saying that you're using your race or something and bring it in. You bring your race into politics, I guess.
Okay, but excuse me.
Uh-oh.
Isn't politics based on race?
Absolutely it is.
So that doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense.
That's just exactly what it is. Like,
so they'll you know, I'll say things and frame it towards black people.
Right.
And then some of my white followers be like, well, that happens in the white community too. Well, I ain't talking about you. I understand it might happen in your community,
but I'm talking about
black people.
That's the problem. They want to be included so damn bad. So they include themselves in our struggles, our issues.
Right.
We don't have the same fight.
And that's what they don't get. They be like, you know, Hotep Jesus, you said something about black people. I am black first.
Like, what am I supposed to be, white?
Right. And you got some black people who will say, oh, that's some Hotep shit. You black first. So what are you first? Some white people ask me, you're not American first? No, I am not American first. I am black first. Then I'm American. Now, if I go to a foreign nation and they holding me up at customs, I'm American first.
No, that's literally what you
are. They pull up my passport.
Right, that's exactly what you are. But
here in the land,
you are black before anything.
I'm black before anything. I am race loyal. Then we could talk about America. Now, here's the thing. People say, then why are you aligned with white people? Because I have come to the understanding that what is good for a white conservative is good for black people. So I'm helping white people out because I see our own interest in it.
Right.
Because if the white people ain't getting rights from America, you know we ain't getting them.
Yeah, we ain't getting them.
If the white man ain't got no rights, we ain't got no rights. So I'm going to fight for the white man to get his rights just so I can get my rights. And people think I'm in it like working for the Republican Party. No, I'm working for myself.
Right.
And assisting white people.
You're just trying to empower and build the community.
Yes.
So we can be a little bit better than what we actually are. But that comes with a lot of work. And a lot of people don't want that work.
They don't want the work.
They don't want the work.
They don't want the work.
It is a lot of work.
Right.
Don't get me wrong. But like you said, you're black first.
Right.
I have a child.
Me too.
Right. So it's like I have to do what I got to do to ensure that my child does not have to deal with, not saying that I've dealt with, you know, certain things, but I understand how the world works.
Right.
And I would hate for her to have to deal with that, especially if you can prevent it.
Right.
So why not be black first and try to ensure that your kids don't have to do that? Build up generational wealth. Be like the white people. Go buy life insurance policies.
Yes.
And build on it. Like,
open
it's little
trust.
Things.
Yes.
Be like the Asians.
Yes.
And I think somebody made a tweet about Asians. Oh, Christian, before he got suspended, he said something about black folks need to basically align themselves like the Asians
yes.
do. And that's basically group economics. Okay? There's nothing wrong with practicing group economics being black.
Yes.
Why? What's the problem?
Right. Nepotism. That's basically where you stick with your own.
Right.
And some of the white conservatives, they get mad when I say I'm sticking with my own. I'm like, well, look, that's what I'm here for. I wouldn't be mad if you wanted to say, yo, I'm a white nationalist.
Right.
I'm going to applaud you. You want to be with white people? Go be with white people. I'm proud of you. Go be with your white people. But don't be mad when Hotep Jesus is with his black people. Look at my YouTube channel. And you ain't going to find not one white person on my YouTube channel. People try to call me a sellout. Every single person I brought on has been black.
Well, you can't be a sellout.
Ain't no way I'm a sellout. Because everything I do for black people.
You surrounded around black people. That's that black empowerment.
Correct.
What is Hotep?
Black first.
Black first.
We got to be black first. If you ain't black first, you ain't for black empowerment.